Hi students, today you are going to learn about heat. In this lesson, what are the contents I am going to teach? About heat, temperature, what are the temperature scales we are using, about mercury, thermometer, different types of thermometers. These contents and all you are going to learn in this topic. First one, we are going to see about heat. What is under heat? Heat is a form of energy. Whenever we are using heat for cooking, for ironing clothes, when running steam engine, for these many purposes we are using heat. What is meant temperature? Temperature means it increases the reliable measure of hotness of an object. That is called what? Temperature. That is the accurate measurement of hotness of an object is called what? Temperature. What are the temperature scales we are using? That is Celsius scale, Fahrenheit scale and Kelvin scale. Then next one is thermometer. What is a thermometer? Thermometer is a device which is used to measure the temperature. Then what? Now we are going to see about mercury. Many metals are there, but in thermometer, which one we are using? Mercury we are using. Why? Yes, why they have selected mercury as a thermometric liquid? Because it has some special features. That's why they have selected mercury as a thermometric liquid. What are the special features? It is shiny in nature. Because of its shiny in nature, we can take the reading easily in thermometer. The boiling point of mercury is 357 degree Celsius. And also this is the only metal which is liquid in room temperature. For these special, because of these special features, we are using mercury in a thermometers. Now we are going to see about different types of thermometers. First one, laboratory thermometer. It is specially designed for lab use. So that we are using, this is the laboratory thermometer. What is the range of level? That is, it is the, compared to all the thermometers, this is large in size. It is large in size. It is a narrow glass tube. The range of laboratory thermometer is 0 degree Celsius to 110 degree Celsius. How we can measure the, by using laboratory thermometer, how we can measure the temperature of chemicals or any liquids by using laboratory thermometer? For which liquid you want to measure, that one you have to keep it in the any one container. Then you have to keep the laboratory thermometer in vertical position. After that, the mercury what you have to, the bulb structure should be dipped into the solution. The bulb structure should not touch the end of the container. Then after that, the mercury level will start raising. In one position, it will remain in the same position. Then we can take the reading. Like this, we have to measure the temperature of chemicals, any chemicals or any liquids by using laboratory thermometer. After measure, after using, we have to keep it, we have to wash proper, then we have to keep it in horizontal position. Why we have to keep it in horizontal position? Because it is a glass. If it is broken, means it is very difficult to dispose because of mercury. So that you have to keep it safe. That's all about the laboratory thermometer. Next one is clinical thermometer. Clinical thermometer, it is used to measure our body temperature. The range of clinical thermometer is 35 to 42 degree Celsius. Why it is in between 35 degree to 42 degree Celsius? Because our, what is our normal body temperature? 37 degree Celsius. So that our body temperature, it will not vary from below 35 and above 42. That's why in clinical thermometer, the range of clinical thermometer is 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. This is the structure of clinical thermometer. One specialization in this clinical thermometer. What is the kink? In this, near to the bulb, there is one curve-like structure is there. That is called what? Kink. What is the use of kink in clinical thermometer? It will prevent the immediate backflow of mercury. That is the specialization of which one? Kink in clinical thermometer. That is where they will keep the clinical thermometer under our tongue. They will keep the thermometer. After few minutes, they will take and note the reading. We have to keep it in a vertical position. We have to keep it in a horizontal position, and we have to take the reading. Then, in this, by using this clinical thermometer, like this, we have to go to you. We have to use for our measure our body temperature. Then next, we are going to see about maximum and minimum thermometer. Maximum and minimum thermometer is used for previous to measure the weather report. This is mainly used for in government meteorological department. They used this thermometer. This what by using this maximum and minimum temperature, what we can do? They will measure the previous day weather report of a place. In this, it is a U-shaped structure. This maximum minimum thermometer is a U-shaped structure. In that, one side it will measure, it will report the maximum temperature. Another side it will measure the record the minimum temperature. For that's why we are saying it is a maximum and minimum thermometer. Another one is last one is digital thermometer. From these three thermometers, what we are using, that is, we are using mercury as a thermometric liquid. To avoid these mercury and glass apparatus, what we are nowadays, what we are using, digital thermometer. Digital thermometer is coated with plastic, and also it is compact in size. This one small button is there, and in digital display is there. In that digital display, in number form, as in number form, we can measure the temperature. We can measure our body temperature. I think all of you understood this lesson till this. From process, just I'm going to recall one time what are the contents I'm teach about heat, personal temperature, then what are the temperature scales, about mercury, then what are the different types of thermometers we used. I hope all you understood. Thank you, students.